I'm doing my PhD in folklore at Memorial University of Newfoundland. And basically what I'm doing here in Shag Harbour is an interpretation history of the Shag Harbour UFO story.
What are you finding?
Well, that there's been a varied interpretation history. It wasn't until newspaper reports began to be published a few days later that, you know, this term UFO appears in headlines. And so kind of people are sort of shocked. You know, what are they talking about UFOs in Shag Harbour?
Here's where we come back and everybody come and watch the light. And here's where the light was first in the water and it drifted there and went out.
Wow. Wow.
So, and here's where the RCMP officer was. There's his car. He was somewhere across there when he see it, and that's where he called it in.
I think it's a very good objective for the human species at this critical moment when we're in this halting and tentative and not fully successful way trying to bind up all the peoples of the earth into what we clearly are, one species and one planet. I think the very thought of there being other beings different from all of us can have a very useful, cohering role for the human species.